Hey everybody, Mark Willis here, and I want to go through what the future holds on your stocks. That's right. I'm pulling out that crystal ball. I'm getting nuts here, and I'm going to tell you what's going to happen in the next 20 years. You might be surprised by the answers. And really the best way we can give you the answers as to the future of the stock market is to go back and see what it's done in the past. So again, my name is Mark Willis, certified financial planner and bank on yourself professional with Not Your Average Financial Podcast and Lake Growth Financial Services. So glad you're joining me here today. This is the only show you can get the future of the stock market with tongue in cheek, of course, inserted there. So let's get into it. I think it's going to be pretty revealing when you realize where we are and where we've come from and where we're headed as a country and as a stock market. So I'm going to share my screen with you here. All right. So best thing I can say first is, obviously, I can't give you official stock advice. This is going to be just our fun way of looking into the future. The real question is, you know, what the heck happened in the past? Because what happened is going to affect what's going to happen. So this is going to talk about where we've been and where we're headed. First, let's go back over the past. In the long term, from 1913 to the early 2000s, we had a fairly steady up and down. There were some pretty dramatic drops, like right there is the Great Depression. And of course, the run up through the 60s and then inflation, stagflation, of course. And then early 80s here was the beginning of the what we call the Roaring 20. According to Les Himmel, who coined the phrase, it's the 20 years from 1980 to 2000 where we had the most incredible run-up of stocks that we've ever seen in our lifetime. Look at that stage there where the markets just went absolutely crazy over that 20-year period. So it's hard to say over the long term, what's the amount you can get as far as a rate of return in the stock market? If you look at the data and you include that 20 years in your data set, it's going to dramatically improve the results of what the stock market should be able to do for you. Now, we cannot repeat the past. So let's ask, why was that 20-year period so unbelievably uncommon for the stock market? Well, a lot of people think there were a lot of factors, of course, but one of the big ones was the baby boomers were coming of age. This is when the boomers were starting to get their jobs. And case in point, they were starting to get 401ks at those jobs. And that meant everybody became a stock market investor by default with that 401k. So when everybody by default is pouring money into the stock market, that's of course going to raise the price of the stock overall. Not to mention other major things happening like the computers revolution, the internet was starting up. There was some major belief that growth curve would just never end. We'd just continue to go sky high into the future from 2000 up to 2020 and beyond. But of course, Wall Street is not a gift from the gods. What goes up must come down. And that's what we saw from 1980 to 2000. We call that the Roaring 20. Now, what happened after 2000, I think will be really helpful for our conversation. We call it not the Roaring 20, but the Boring 20. And really, that's quite literally what it was. There were sections, major sections of this 20-year period where we just lost ground. We had no real growth. Of course, we had major drops like 2001 and 2008. Those were major market corrections followed by deep recessions in the economy, especially 2008, 9, and 10. But there was a 20-year period where we essentially had very little growth. Very little growth. In fact, I took a picture of the S&P 500 from 2000 to about 2013. And the results, if you had put all your money in 2000 and then just waited, by 2013, you would have gone through two major drops, as you can see here. But after 2013, we basically were back even. Really no change after 13 years. So no change in your money after going tumbling down twice, major stock market crashes. But there was actually a change, wasn't there? The change was now we have had 13 more birthdays on our calendar and we're 13 years closer to our retirement years. So we call it the Boring 20, but honestly, it's like a slow grade anxiety build because we're getting older every year and that stock market wasn't doing enough to keep up. In fact, according to third-party research, the real results of actual investors before taxes If you had your money split between stocks and bonds or index funds, like most people have, your real return over the last 30 years from 1990 to 2020 is 2.29%. Now that looks pretty boring to me. And of course, the only way you could get some major growth is if you look at a shorter time horizon and like 12 months or 3 years, and if you were all in on stocks. But again, are we in this for short term, like a 12 months or 3 months, or are we in this for long term, like 30 years? Most real investors are doing this for their retirement, which means they're putting money into their 401ks for a long period of time, or their IRAs for a long period of time. And the real results, the stats are in, according to Dalbar's quantitative analysis of an investor behavior study for 2020, 2.29% is the average asset allocation return for fund investors. That's your index funds, your bond funds. That's pathetic. That's way below even inflation. Not to mention, we've got to still pay our taxes on that return, which makes the results even less. Unfortunately, that's the boring 20. And here's another example of what I mean. So from 2000 to the end of 2016, where I stopped the data, there was a 5% change in the index value. So from 2000 all the way to the very end, all start of 2017, you might say, 5% was the return. So that's even including the run-up that we've recently gone through in the last 11 years before 2020's pandemic brought the stock market to its knees in March of 2020. So everyone says, well, hey, if you make 5% on your index change here, that's going to be the same thing as the 5% on my 401k portfolio. I got a 5% return in the market. That's what the market says. I've got an index fund. I track the index all the way. I should have exactly what the index shows. Well, unfortunately, no. If you put $100 into the stock market in 2000 and waited and then opened up your account at January 1st, 2017, you'd only have a $169, which constitutes a 3.3% return, not 5%. Why is that? Well, the total percent change from start to finish was 5% growth. And that's a cumulative rate of return, by the way. So why the change? Why the difference? The difference is volatility. Volatility throws us for a loop because when you move up and down and sideways, it's a lot harder. You need to move a lot more to keep up with the straight line projection. Consider with me for just a minute before we move on. If you need to go to the grocery store, the dry cleaners, pick up the kids from soccer practice, go across town again to pick up some dinner and then head home, won't that use a lot more energy than just going straight from the office back home right away? Of course, it's the same concept with your stock portfolio. If your stock portfolio goes way up and then way down, way up and way down, it's going to cause a lot more need for higher returns to keep up with a straight, steady, boring rate of return. So that's what I mean when I say the cumulative rate of return is less than the actual percentage change. All right, so now for what you've all been waiting for, this is the next 20 years. Where's the market headed? I'm going to call this the pouring 20, P-O-O-R-I-N-G. The next 20 years are going to be the pouring 20. And I hate to be a bummer like this. We do have some good news, so wait till the end here. But the next 20 years are going to involve the boomers retiring. And it's going to involve higher taxes due to the deficits and higher obligations the government has to pay those deficits and the interest on the debt. So when the market boomed in the roaring 20 that we saw earlier, you saw the stock market go crazy high in part because the boomers were getting into the labor force. Now, from 2020 to 2040, we all expect these boomers are going to start retiring and start needing that 401k money, taking it out to buy groceries at the grocery store. All that money is going to come out of the stock market and is going to get spent on things that the boomers need. And so that's going to be sucking wind out of the market when taxes are going to be going up. So I don't have a crystal ball, and I'm sorry to burst that bubble there, but there's probably going to be some pretty significant changes in what we can expect from the stock market going forward. We can also expect higher taxes with unfunded obligations on the government's part and hyper and larger inflation as well. So we've got that to look forward to. I think there's going to be also significant changes to what we can expect from our stock portfolios. So with that in mind, what's some good news? What if you didn't have to hope and pray that the market was going to do the decades that you wanted it to do? What if you didn't have to worry about the roaring 20, the boring 20, or the pouring 20? What if you could have a soaring 20 all by yourself and make it yours? What if you could own the outcome of your financial strategy before you even started the plan? What if you knew every year what your minimum guaranteed net worth was going to be before you even put the plan into place, before you even started funding the accounts? That would sound like financial peace. So that's what I'd like to talk to you about as we wrap up. Here's a gentleman who had a typical portfolio during the boring 20 here from 2000 to 2009. He was running the regular rat race and putting money into his investment accounts. This is Dan Proskauer, who gave us his real net worth chart. And right there in June of 2009, he opened up his first bank on yourself type whole life policy, which grows on a guaranteed basis every single year, where that blue arrow is there. And as he continued to see it funded and grow, he knew that it would grow on a guaranteed basis every year. Look at the net worth as he began to build real wealth. This is not paper wealth like the stock market crash or the rise and fall of the tech bubble. No, this is literally tripling his net worth in 10 years. And the principal and gains on a policy like this, like a bank on yourself type policy, is locked in. That's real wealth. So we're very happy with his performance. And he's just one of hundreds of thousands of people who have these strategies set up around the country. So again, guys, you have the ability to own the outcome of your financial life before you even get started. And you don't have to worry about what 20-year period you might be situated in or what the stock market might look like 20 years from now. It won't matter if you've got your policies set up. It won't matter if you've got your cash in the right place, if you've told your money what you want it to do for you, and if you've owned the outcome of your financial plan before you even get started. So I'd be happy to chat with you about this. If you'd like to learn more about what this can do for you, go to nyafinancialpodcast.com, click on request a meeting, and be happy to sit down and talk to you about what this looks like in your circumstance. So whether you're in the roaring 20, the boring 20, or the pouring 20, I want to make sure that your life, your financial future is soaring. So have a great rest of your day.